Okay, good morning everyone. Welcome to this webinar that we're running on the PG Certificate in Clinical Bioinformatics that we're running at the University of Manchester. I'm Dr. Ange Davies, and this is my colleague.
Hello, I'm Fran Hooley.
Okay, so what we'd like to do in this next few minutes is just take you through the background of the course, what it includes, a little bit more detail about how it works, how the study works, how the assessment works, and then where this course might take you after you've completed it. And then at the end of the webinar, there'll be some opportunity for some questions. So we'll keep the slides fairly snappy, so you've got the most opportunity to ask us questions at the end, because when we ran this previously, that's where the most value seemed to come through. Okay. Let's make a start. Okay. So I've been involved for some last 6 or 7 years with leading a master's program in clinical bioinformatics that underpins the training of clinical bioinformaticians working in our healthcare system in the UK and the NHS. I've really worked very closely with the students because over the last few years, the genomics landscape, certainly in the UK, has really rapidly evolved. We're now delivering whole genome sequencing in our healthcare system. So it's really important that we have clinical bioinformaticians that can underpin and help us to analyse all that sequence information. So I work closely with the students to evolve the programme really rapidly and make sure it's really fit for purpose for their training within the NHS. And that knowledge and that experience is now really fed into this online course that we've developed over the last 18 months or so.
So my background is e-learning design. So I've been a technology enhanced designer for the last 10 years, but then I've been immersed within the area of clinical bioinformatics since 2016 within higher education. So my role has been as a deputy PD to support the educational methods that we use and the approach that we take. To make sure as distance learners you're supported. I'm also co-leading on the third unit for the introduction to programming.
Thanks, Fran. Okay, so a bit more background around this course and is this course right for you? So the way we've developed the course is really to focus on clinical bioinformaticians working in an applied healthcare environment. And we've taken to date a wide variety of people, largely from healthcare, but not exclusively, some from more research backgrounds. So these are people that may be bioscientists, biomedical background, some clinicians. We've had people with much more computer science or informatics background. And also we might have people such as clinical scientists wanting to change direction a little bit in the career they're working in within healthcare. So as you can see, we kind of judge each application on its own merits and depending on your individual qualifications and or experience and background. So the idea is that we've developed it and embedded it with really applied clinical case studies inserted throughout all of your learning. And the idea is that it's a very flexible course. So we've developed it so that you can do any of the units as a continuing professional development. We try to encourage that if you're going to do that, if you're going to do the unit 4, which is much more on applied next generation sequencing and looking at gene panels, I'll discuss that in more detail in a minute, that you actually should really do the first unit around introduction to clinical bioinformatics first. But again, we judge each application for continuing professional development on its own merit and according to everybody's experience. And we'll talk in a few more slides about where this might take you. Mm-hmm. Okay, so we'll go through each of the units in a little bit more detail. So the first unit, which I'm the unit lead for, is an introduction to clinical bioinformatics. And this really takes you through introduction to genomics, molecular biology, kind of 101 as we call it. So really getting down to the basics of molecular biology, then moving quite rapidly into introducing bioinformatics, thinking about the tools and the databases that we might use within a clinical setting, particularly focused on analysing single nucleotide variants. And we use, again, all of those are taken from real clinical case studies. And we've got some basic lectures in there around how next generation sequencing works and some of the other technologies too.
So the second unit, Introduction to Health Informatics, is structured into 3 different parts. The first part looks at clinical coding. And throughout the whole of the unit, there's practical, you know, practice-based activities to support it. They look at electronic patient records and information sharing, and then round up on the third area on human factors. So the third unit, Introduction to Programming, this is looking at Python. We have structured this so that it's very practical based. You'll be working on GitHub within one of the repos there and working through the materials which are chunked up into Jupyter notebooks, which just allows you to do step by step in terms of your coding pace. We're very much trying to emulate practice in terms of how we do this, you know, within a project. So we use a lot of group-based learning, and also we use agile methodologies in order to look at the practice-based activities and make sure that they're real world and authentic. So really trying to make it immersive and also applicable to people who have never done programming before, to ones that are quite conversant with it. So it's a range of skills that we cater for.
Okay, so the fourth unit is Introduction to Next Generation Sequencing Bioinformatics. So this is much more focused on the bioinformatics pipeline. So how do you analyse that sequencing data that comes off a sequencing machine? What does the pipeline look like? What do each of the stages do in that analysis pipeline? And actually gets you working on a real pipeline. And we're going to be using an environment called Galaxy to do that, in which is a really useful tool for teaching in. And we delve into some of the algorithms and how they work, so you can understand what some of the options are and why you might use some different tools for doing that analysis. We'll also focus on some of the clinical guidelines and all the time these have been developed, and that will build on that first unit where it's that very sort of clinical focus looking at single variants. And we'll introduce starting to think about copy number variants as well, so larger variations in the genome too. Again, focus here as well, we come back to the ethical and confidentiality issues that might arise with doing next generation sequencing, thinking about things like incidental findings, secondary findings, and so on. So that will also be in there. Again, as with the first unit, you'll have different ways of working. So you'll do an individual presentation, but you'll also contribute to the shared knowledge, contributing to a discussion board and working together with your peers in the online environment on the course.
So in terms of the structure of the course, it's all fully online. It's covered over 12 months if you do the full PG cert. Each one is four units are 15 credit modules. And we're averaging out in terms of 15 hours worth of study each week. But with a view to that, when you start each of the units, there'll be kind of a bit of a lead in terms of extra activity, and it will kind of taper out when we look at the assessment near the end. So you've got enough time to kind of do the work and work through each of the weeks to reach the assessment. As I mentioned, each one is 10 weeks long. Assessment for each of the units is structured into three parts. And assessment for discussion is also included as 20% of the marks for each of the units. So we've incorporated this because we want to support your learning as distance learners, and having that social element really sort of reduces the sense of isolation whilst you're working, you know, and trying to juggle everything. It's great to have that group work. But we also wanted to put marks against that group work, and we assess kind of how you work together as a team, and throughout each of those 10 weeks there'll be key points where we either have a webinar, or on some of the units we're just looking at online discussion threads and seeing how you contribute, and not just your own knowledge but also how you contribute within the group. So yes, that's one of the key things just to remember in terms of the assessment. And then the other assessment pieces are related to each of the course units sort of knowledge base. So, just going to the next slide. Mm-hmm. So in terms of entry requirements, Andrew's already mentioned that we look at each application on its own merit, but as a basis, we welcome people to one honours degree within the areas that you can see on the slide, so medical, biological. We've had an array of different backgrounds, real different background, people coming from IT, people coming from clinical practice. And also we've got the fees on there in terms of the PG cert, £3,900 for the full PG cert, and then the CPD per unit is £1,100. So we've run this already, we're in the middle of unit three, we're about to launch unit four, but the units will start again in May onwards. I think, have we mentioned that to do unit four, you need to have done unit one
in advance
of that, but all the others, you can do them in a sequence of your own choosing. So that's kind of the practical element.
Okay, so we've had a lot of questions in the past with other applications of where will this take me. So hopefully you've got an idea that genomics is really rapidly evolving at the moment. As I say, within the UK, we've moved from gene panels to whole genome sequencing in a clinical setting over just a short number of years, from in the last sort of 2 or 3 years, really. So it might help you to decide where you want to, if you want to take a change of direction in your career, you might be able to actually take a more sort of translational bioinformatics role, so working into much more applied environment in a healthcare setting and making sure your knowledge and experience is translated within that clinical setting. You might decide to do some further study with us, so we have a master's in genomic medicine that you might be able to use some of this learning within the PG certificate to take across to this course. You might use it to build new collaborations. So as we said, we encourage this sort of development of a community practice and a network within the course. So it might be that this encourages you and you actually decide you want to pursue much more of a research career or a research project. And certainly what we're seeing is this is a really growing area. Clinical bioinformaticians, certainly in the UK, are really developing. They're being looked to develop the genomic workforce. So this is a rapidly evolving area for us. As we said, you're going to develop a global network. We've had students from Costa Rica, Nepal, Greece, so really a global community of practice. You'll be able to communicate with all those colleagues in these discussion forums, and who knows where some of those discussions might take you in your careers. You'll hopefully learn something from working with us. So we interact in the discussion forums and we do synchronous tutorials. So we try to bring in live content of the course and things that are happening at that moment in time within genomics. We're still continuing to train the bioinformaticians working in the NHS. So we'll also bring all that knowledge across to you.
So in terms of online study, as I mentioned before, we really want to make sure that you're supported as a distance learner. So we've got, with UMW University Manchester Worldwide, we've got a study advisor who will support you on the non-academic side of your studies. But then we've also got each lead, the educators for each of the units will be there to support you. And as with the discussions online, you'll have contact and especially webinars that are run throughout each of the units as well. You will get direct contact with your educators. In terms of content as well, we've got, if you're still deciding, we've got a MOOC, a Clinical Bioinformatics MOOC on the FutureLearn platform, which possibly will run in September. Details will follow, and we'll put that on the website. But essentially that's 5 weeks, 2 hours per week. It's a free online course, which takes you through the introduction to clinical bioinformatics, looking at pipelines, and some authentic case studies that we've worked with here in Manchester with bioinformaticians here to pull together. One quick mention also is in terms of the materials that you'll be using, it's using a tool called RISE, which will give you quite structured approach to your studies step by step, so you can go through and pace yourself, all signposted, and we've had some great feedback in terms of using that as a tool. We've also got the wealth of where we are in University of Manchester. We've got the library with their award-winning materials to support your learning as well, such as My Learning Essentials, being able to be critical, note-making, there's a wealth of online materials just waiting to sort of help you with your studies. And that was really an essential thing we wanted to get across, that you will get support.
Okay. So hello, my name's Katie. So I'm the course advisor for clinical bioinformatics. So I'm here to answer any of your questions regarding non-academic application process, or whether you're the right fit for the course, or any entry requirements as well. So you may have already received a few emails from me, but if you would like to contact me today anyway, it's at studyonline@manchester.ac.uk. And you're more than welcome to give me a phone call as well. So I think we've got a few questions that have come through at the moment, which we can answer now. So the first question that we received is, do I need any knowledge of programming prior to the course?
So I did mention this when we went through the slides. No, you don't. So we've got myself and Pete, run the course, but we've also got facilitators who are there on a weekly basis. We're using Slack, which is a tool which supports discussions and supports discussions as teams. And what we, you know, for each of those weeks, we're there to support you at an allotted time each one. It's each Wednesday, 4 till 6 currently. So you will get support. And I mentioned before, in terms of the materials that we're using Jupyter Notebooks, and that is very much an online like lab book where you'll have teaching materials or materials learning content that you'll run through, and then there's segments for coding. So you can try, it's in a safe environment. There's, you know, essentially we want you to do it by step by step and be comfortable as you go through it, so you don't need to have the background in programming. And just to sort of end that, in terms of the support you'll have, the educators, you'll have the facilitator, but also the way we've structured the content is that you are working in teams, and it's all around working together as you would do back at the coal face. You would work in teams to go through any kind of coding. So that's what we're trying to emulate with the course.
Is it worth just adding, Fran? So the language that we use will be Python, which is the one that's tended to be used by bioinformaticians working in healthcare to develop bioinformatics pipelines. So if you're really keen, certainly if you get in touch with us, we can, and you want to learn more, there are bits and pieces that you could do and or look at in advance. So we'd be happy to signpost there.
Mm-hmm. Excellent, thank you. Another question, do you recommend any reading literature before taking the course?
So we've obviously we've talked about the MOOC. I think the MOOC is one of the most valuable things that you could do to really get a flavour of the area, etc. What we've done when we've designed the course, certainly unit one, is that we've got a large number of integrated embedded reading materials. So if you were really keen, certainly we could signpost you to some of those in advance, but it's really embedded within the course when you start. It's not expected that you would access those before, but again, if you're keen, we'd be happy to signpost beforehand.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. Another question from a student. I'm graduating from my bachelor's in medical biochemistry this year. Would it be advisable for me to do a master's in bioinformatics or this PhD certificate, as most jobs I've seen ask for a minimum of a master's or a PhD?
Okay, Yeah, it's a tricky one. So certainly we would expect at the end of this course, you will be able to code. You're not gonna have the experience of a research project that you would within a master's. This is something, obviously, we might evolve the course. This might happen in the longer term, but it's certainly we're not doing it right now. What I would say is it would work very well with if you're working in an applied health environment where you can sort of translate and apply those skills quite rapidly and start to test them in a sort of safe but real world applied example. So my expectation is that by the time you come out at the end of this, that you should be able to go away and actually code. For example, a lot of the first clinical bioinformaticians that came through in the NHS were very much with that kind of background. They did a bit of coding, were very self-taught. So I think certainly this will get you a lot further than that. So I think certainly, you know, a recognised bona fide qualification. And certainly if you can say you've been learning alongside or certainly taught by the people that have trained those working in the NHS, the bioinformaticians working in the NHS, then that's, you know, going to be very valuable.
Thank you. Another question, how do you assess the course?
So we mentioned that for each of the units that there's three parts of the assessment. One part of the assessment is discussion. So 20% for all four units is discussion online, which we mentioned the benefits for earlier. And then there's two other components, one's at 50% and one's at 30%. And it depends on each of the units. So for your particular unit, for unit one, there is a presentation and then there's also a report.
Yes,
so it's all clinical reports. So they're all geared around the actual unit that you can undertake, but each one is very much similar in that you've got that discussion, presentation, and then either a report or a piece of coding, depending on which unit.
I think the important thing to add is there's no exams.
Yes.
So
yes,
it's all
throughout
discussion or assignment based.
Yeah. So I mean, there's benefits in terms of not having the exam at the end of it, or but it's the involvement during the course and building up your learning as you go and doing the assessment as you go. You know, with the assessed discussion and building up the presentation as you go. You know, it's kind of, it builds. So.
Yeah. You have to realise that, I guess, that there's going to be a commitment throughout those 10 weeks is the key point.
Mm-hmm. More of a broad question. How could this PG certificate help and inform my career?
Oh, good question. I think certainly it depends what your background is, whoever that is that's asked that course, that question. It's certainly going to, if you've certainly much more from a research background, it's going to whet your appetite in terms of, you know, what it's like to work in a more clinical setting. So we cover a lot around the professional guidelines, the clinical guidelines that you'd be working to as a bioinformatician, ISO accreditation, which is actually quite different to working as a bioinformatician working in research. So it'll certainly give you that flavour. It might also give you, it might be that you come out of it and decide that actually I just want to do coding for my own sort of fun, but actually maybe it's the genomics that I'm really interested in. So I think it would give you, it would certainly give you a flavour of both the clinical genomics and also the very applied bioinformatics.
And another question, what is the application process? So I can answer that one. So if you go to our website, you can find the application form there. If you scroll down to application selection, you can download the form from there. Once you've completed that form, you then send it to the email address that's on the form. So it's worldwideapplications@manchester.ac.uk. And if you send all your supporting evidence, so it'll tend to ask you for your degree certificate, maybe a transcript, possibly a CV, and then it will be assessed by our admissions team, and then they will assess you for whether you're suitable for the course. But if you do have any more specific questions around the application process, you can just drop me an email and I can always send you across the application form as well. Another question, is there any difference between online and on-campus degree that we receive? Are they both equivalent?
Yeah, absolutely, they are both equivalent. You might be learning as a distance student, but the process, the rigour, all the academic processes that go on behind the scenes that fortunately you don't sort of see, so how we support you, the fact that actually all of our marks are moderated, the experience that you'll get should be just the same as someone, the same kind of support that we'd expect someone on campus to get. So yeah, absolutely, same degree type, you know, the PG certificate, the fact that it's done online, it will still just be called a PG certificate. If you choose to, you can come to our graduations on site as well when they happen. That's up to you, really. So yeah, there's absolutely no difference.
No. It's also worth noting that on your PG certificate that you get through, it won't mention anything about online or part-time as well, which is sometimes a question that we get as well. Okay, so I think that's all the questions that we've had today. If, however, you have any further questions that you think of, again, just drop us an email and I can always forward this on to both of you if it's more academic based. But I hope you found that really informative and we hope to see you soon.
Thank you.
Thanks for listening.
Bye.